Hello students, yesterday we have discussed the previously asked question in the theoretical OSFATs from the chapter Semiconductor Devices, and now let's continue our discussion on that. Means the question that is based on this chapter that is asked from in last 10 years, so let's see that. So in that case, as we have discussed already, how can we categorize any material based on two models that we have, like pre-electron model and band model. Secondly things, as here in this chapter we will study only about the semiconductor devices, means the devices that is made up of the semiconductor material. So basically, as we have discussed what is semiconductor material, how many types of semiconductor material, and the most important topic that is p-n junction diode, in which the important topic like depletion region or formation of depletion layer, barrier potential, forward bias, reverse bias, and its characteristic. So I think all that case and breakdown in the reverse bias, that all is clear. Now let's see in the rectifier first. After that we will discuss special purpose diode. So questions are asked from every topic from this chapter. Means like a question is asked from p-n junction diode, it is asked from rectifiers, it is asked from all the special purpose diodes. So in case of rectifier, one question is asked, that is draw the circuit diagram of half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. In next question it is asked, state the working of half wave rectifier and draw its output characteristics or output waveform. In the same way, one question is asked for full wave rectifier, draw the circuit diagram of full wave rectifier and state its working, and also draw the output waveform for it. So simple, it means as a whole, if you will see, it is asked half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. So here I will discuss whole of the things at one place, whole of the questions at one place here. So first of all, a rectifier, you know that it is a device which converts AC signal, alternating signal, into direct signal or direct current, clear? So if we are talking about the alternating voltage, it will convert into just direct current, direct voltage. If we are giving alternating current, it will convert into the direct current. So simple, you can say that the device which converts alternating signal into direct signal. So here two types of devices we have, and now here in this case we are going to study the application of diodes. So as symbol of diode, you know already, this is the symbol of diode, in which this side is P side, this is N side. So how can we use diodes in our daily life? So let's see that now. And also in special purpose diodes, we have used the properties of diode there by making that diodes, and that particular diodes we are using at different places. So this rectifier is the example application of p-n junction diode. First of all, I am going to give you example for the just use of p-n junction diode here. So first types of rectifier that we have, half wave rectifier. So by name, as it is given, half wave, so in output you will see that we will get half wave only. So in this case, first of all, let's draw a circuit diagram. So for the circuit diagram, it is very easy, and I will draw it from the starting. Let's try to understand, and the way in which I am drawing it, you will be means it will be written in your mind always. So in this case, first of all, as the signal that we have to rectify, let's apply it to any transformer. So you know that in transformer we have two coils. One is secondary for primary and other one is secondary. So according to our need, we can make it a step up, a step down transformer. So you know how to make a step up, how to make a step down transformer. So basically here, as we have to get output signal here, and here we are getting low signal, then definitely we will use always step up transformer here. So this is signal, this is transformer. Now we have just applied this signal after going through the transformer to any diode. So suppose this diode is capital D, and now to take the output, we can use any load here. So we can take output through the load. So this is simple circuit diagram for the half wave rectifier. Meaning means the signal or that we have to rectify, that will be applied to transformer. After that it will be applied to diode, and after that the output will be taken from any load R and become the AC. Now let's see how this wave will be rectified by this one diode that we have used here. So in this case, one thing that you have to remind in your mind, and sometimes questions can be asked, but it is not asked even yet, but still it can be asked. Write down the limitation for the diode in the case of rectifiers. So here the diode D that we are using, that is ideal type diode, means its resistivity is infinite. Means whenever we will connect this diode in reverse bias, then that time it will give us zero current. No current we will get in the output. Either there is minority charge carrier present in the system also. So in that case, simple means whenever reverse bias will be there, diode will be in non-conducting state. No current will be flowed from it. Second thing, whenever it will be in forward bias, then that time a large current that will be obtained from this device. Secondly thing, obviously resistance is zero, I just told you. That's why in reverse bias we are getting no current. Next one thing is also, here the signal that we are applying, its voltage should be less than the breakdown voltage of this diode. So here the diode that you will choose, that should always breakdown voltage greater than the signal. Otherwise signal here breakdown will be occur in this diode D, and even in reverse bias we will get again signal, means again we will get alternating signal in the output. So that signal will not be rectified. Rectifying any signal means, as in the case of AC signal, you have seen that signal has two direction. Half of the signal is in positive direction, half is in the negative direction. So if we will convert this two directional signal into one direction, means only we will get half positive signal in this way in place of this negative, then that time we can call it, this is now direct current, this is going in only one direction. So it's such types of current we have to use in the circuit. So obviously if diode will start to convert in reverse bias, that time we will not get any rectified signal. Let's see how can we understand it. So now I'm just going to talk about the working construction and circuit diagram I just told you. So let's see its working. So for working, suppose this is our signal, input signal. And now in this AC signal, we just applied half positive half signal to this transformer. So whenever this positive half cycle will fed to this transformer, then the end, suppose this end is A, this end is B. So this end will become positive, and with respect to this end, obviously this end will be negative. So if this end is positive, it means that the P type of P side of the diode, that will be connected to positive, and N side of the diode will be connected to negative. Means diode will be in forward bias. You know that whenever diode, the signal is connected to, means positive signal is connected to P type, negative is connected to N side, diode is called forward bias, in forward bias. And we have just understood that case already. So whenever means diode is in forward bias in this case. So if diode is in forward bias, I just told you, diode is of ideal type, that time diode will conduct and current that will flow through the circuit. So if current will flow through it, then that time if it will pass through the load, then we can just take output from this load here. So the output will be I into RL here. So we will go according to, we will get according to the voltage in the output. So as it is the same voltage we will get that we have applied here in this case. Clear? Secondly thing, if we will apply this negative half cycle to this transformer, then that time due to application of this negative here, this end A will become non-negative, and with respect to this A terminal, this end will become positive. So this will be a negative, this will be a positive. So it means that now this diode D, its P side is connected to negative and N side is connected to positive now. So if you know that P side is connected to negative, N side is connected to positive, that time diode is in reverse bias state. So as I told you already, we are taking ideal type diode whose resistivity is resistance is infinite. So in that case, obviously diode will not conduct in the reverse bias. And also one more condition I told you, here the breakdown voltage of this diode is greater than the signal we have taken in the input. So it means that here whenever the diode is in reverse bias, it will be below its critical voltage, below its breakdown voltage. And in that case, in that distance or curve, you know that only minority carriers dominate there, and if diode's resistance is infinite, then minority carriers also will not flow through the circuit. It means the, or simple in another way you can say that in ideal case diode only majority carriers are present, minority carriers are zero there. Means no thermal agitations will be possible there, only all of the majority carriers are obtained through the doping processes. So simple in reverse bias diode will not conduct. So obviously in this case for the negative half cycle, this diode will not conduct, so no current will be flowed through the circuit, and due to that no current will be obtained in the output here. Again positive half cycle we will get, and the same procedure will be repeated for positive, negative, positive, negative. So obviously for this negative we haven't get any signal. Again for positive we will get signal, again for negative we will not get signal. Okay? So in this way you can see that this is the output waveform, this is input waveform, this is output waveform, and in the output only half of the wave we are getting and half of the wave we are not getting here. So that's why its name is half wave rectifier here. So I think students, the principle, working, construction, circuit diagram, everything is clear. So let's discuss the full wave rectifier. So again, as in the case of half wave rectifier, this half signal was reduced from here. So to gain it, we just try to do the same procedure by using two diodes in the circuit. And we have applied two diodes in this way, and again, forward bias they will conduct, in reverse bias they will not conduct. Third, it's their breakdown is greater than the signal that we have applied here. So this is the circuit diagram for this. One circuit diagram if you have reminded, second one you can easily draw through that. So if this is now clear, then let's see the procedure for the or working for the full wave rectifier again. So in this case now, if we have applied this positive half cycle to transformer, then in that case, obviously due to application of positive half cycle, this terminal A will become positive, and with respect to that, this terminal B will become negative here. So if A is positive, B is negative, again you can see from here A, this P is connected to positive, it means that diode is in forward bias, and here P is connected to negative, it means that diode is in reverse bias. So this diode D2 is here, this time this is in reverse bias and this is in forward bias condition. So it means that diode D1 will conduct as it is, is in forward bias, but diode D2 will not conduct as it is in reverse bias. So for this diode, current will flow through it, and again we will get output with respect to that. So let's see the output. I am just showing here. So due to this current, if I1 current is flowing through it, this I1 will go through it, and we will get a voltage according to this. Yeah? Now let's see what will be if we are taking negative half cycle here. So when a negative half cycle will fed to this transformer, that time this signal, this terminal will become negative again, and this will be with respect to that positive. So if this is negative, this is positive, then again this diode P is connected to negative. Now this diode will be in reverse bias, and this diode, that is P is connected to positive, then that will comes in forward bias. Now so this condition we were not getting in half wave, and now we are getting here in this case. This is in forward bias, this is in reverse bias. Means now this diode D2 will conduct, but D1 will not conduct, as it is in reverse bias condition. So current I2 will flow through it, and due to that we will get an output in here. And obviously that current is flowing in the same phase as flowing in the first case, then due to same phase we will get output waveform in the same phase also. Now we have seen, for one complete cycle we are getting one complete cycle in only one direction, only the positive signals we have got here. Again we will apply positive half signal, then again we will get the outputs. For negative half cycle we will get the output here. So continually we will get such types of output in the. So this is the output waveform for the full wave rectifier. So by name you have understood that as we are getting full wave, means full wave conduction for this AC signal, and that's why it names is full wave rectifier. So I think students, the circuit diagram construction working of half wave and full wave, that is clear now. So if this is clear, again I told you, just work on the circuit diagrams, try to construct it by yourself number of times, all the circuits at one place, so that you can remind it easily. So next is that the case of special purpose diodes. So what is a special purpose diode? As you know that here we have two properties of PN junction diode. One is forward bias property, second is reverse bias. Means we are using the forward bias condition or reverse bias condition, and we have made so many diodes that works in forward bias or they can work in reverse bias. So they are called the special purpose diode. Means for our special purpose we have designed that diode. So in your syllabus you have to study four special purpose diodes. First is Zener diode, second is photodiode, third is LED, and fourth is solar cell. And questions are asked from all four topics. Means first question if I will take here, so first one is photodiode here. Let's take that first. So in the case of photodiodes, here number of questions are asked. First, what is the circuit diagram for photodiodes? Second thing, what is the principle of photodiode? Third thing, why we are using photodiode in reverse bias? So in that way, number of conceptual problems we have also, that is asked in your examination paper already. So let's discuss all the things here. So as first of all, photodiode is an alternative of photocells. So as we have discussed, photocells in the case of dual nature of radiation and matter, means like photocell, the working principle of photocell is photoelectric emission. So as it is, photodiode is also worked on photoelectric emission. So in this case, as whenever one diode we have, suppose this is the PN junction diode that we have. This is the depletion region, and as the depletion region is formed, we know that conduction is stopped there. to start the conduction we have to apply the external circuit or any external battery to it. So if we will not use or suppose any external battery that we have used here, so and also suppose I am just connecting it in reverse bias, later I will tell you why I am doing so. So this is positive, this is negative, and a fixed voltage that we have put here. So in this case, if we have just put here fixed voltage, then how can we vary current through it? So we are using an external source as the light source here to vary the current through it. So this junction is exposed by electromagnetic radiation here. So such types of construction is known as photodiode. So basically, first you know that the principle of photodiode, first of all let's discuss that. So principle of photodiode is photoelectric emission. Whenever light will fall on any material or light of suitable frequencies fall on any material, then that time electrons get ejected from there. So in this case you know that whenever electron will eject, then a hole will be created, a vacancy will be created behind that. This is always an electron hole pair that will be generated due to this external light source. This is the principle of photodiode. Now let's understand why we are using it only in reverse bias. Question is asked already in the conceptual question. So in this case, the reason lies behind our purpose. In starting, I told you that we are just discussing a special purpose diode. So this is our purpose to make this diode, to use it in that places where we can use a small current, or we can just calculate the intensity of radiation. So if we have to calculate intensity of radiation, then you know that according to photon picture of radiation, intensity of radiation is directly proportional to the number of photons, and number of photons are directly proportional to the number of electrons ejected from any material surface. This is the law of photoelectric emission that you know already. Now we have just discussed before it. So it means that if we will measure the number of carriers present or that is ejected from here, then by help of that number of carriers we can calculate what is the intensity of the incidence radiation there. So I think now that is clear what is our purpose to make it. Now to make it that purpose, why we can't use it in forward bias? So in the case of forward bias, you know that there are majority carriers that are in dominating nature. Means whenever we will connect the circuit is in forward bias, then that time a large number of carriers that will cross to the junction easily, and when we will expose this depletion region by any electromagnetic radiation of suitable frequency, then some of the electron hole pair will be generated. But already there are a large amount, in large amount there is number of carriers, and if you will just plot the forward characteristics, then there will be not much impact due to that incidence. Very small effect will be there. So that small effect will not show anything. Means we cannot understand the how many electrons or how many holes are ejected due to this exposure here. But if we will take reverse bias characteristic or reverse biasing here, so in the case of reverse biasing, as you know that before the breakdown voltage, so here one more thing, the voltage that we are taking, that is constant voltage, and this voltage is much below the breakdown voltage. So whenever light, we will apply light here, means if it is below the breakdown, no breakdown current we are getting, and you know that below the breakdown voltage, we are getting current only due to minority carriers here, means very few current we are getting. So whenever we just apply this reverse bias to here, no exposure of lights we will have, then some of the currents we will get here in this way. So as we are taking this voltage below the breakdown, so I am not taking that part of characteristic here, only this part where we are getting the current due to minority carriers I am taking. So this current is known as dark current, means when we are not using any electromagnetic radiation. Now, if we will expose this region with electromagnetic radiation, then that time obviously electron hole pair will be generated here, and due to that electron hole pair, the current will start to increase suddenly. And if already you know that minority carriers have been very few amount, and here number of charge carriers will be increased, then due to that there will be a large amount, large change in current will occur. So it means that we will get large change in the graph due to that. If we will start to increase the intensity, then obviously here the current that will start to change here. So with the measurement of this current, we can easily compare. If we have just applied suppose three lights of different intensities, then or one light at different intensity, then we can compare or we can see the current here, and you know that current is also directly proportional to the number of electrons. So by measuring the current, we can easily understand how the intensity changed. Means here we were getting this current when any type of radiation is exposed to this surface, but when we just expose this by some light, and that time we are getting this amount of this difference of current. So that's why, as we can measure easily, we can calculate easily number of carriers in the reverse bias case, we are using this photodiode in reverse bias. So the reason is behind our purpose. Our purpose is here to just measure the intensities of radiation to calculate number of photons in the radiation. That time number of electrons and the current, that will help of us a lot. So that's why we are using this procedure there, and we are using such types of biasing there. So I think student, now that is clear why we always connect photodiode in reverse bias. There is always a reason why we are using only certain bias in certain diodes. So I will tell you all the conceptual question here that is asked already in your examination. So if that thing is clear, now let's see its working. So its working is very simple. Characteristics you have seen. This is the characteristics of photodiode. Means when we will not expose this junction by any light, then that time only small current we will get due to minority carriers present in this PN junction diode. And when we start to expose it by some light of some intensity, then due to intensity we are getting some of the current increased here. And again, if we will increase intensity, there will be increment in current also according to that. And we can just compare the intensities easily, or we can calculate its intensities of radiation there. So and now, how, where we can use the photodiode? So here question is very simple. Construction, working principle, on why, what types of biasing we are using, and later at last where we are using these diodes. So first use I just told you, we are using photodiodes to measure the intensities of radiation, or we can measure simple the light coming from the stars and its intensity, that we can measure. All the application that we were studied in the case of photocells, that we can do here with the help of photodiodes. We can use photodiodes in automatic doors and counter circuits, in any seminar functions to count the number of people there. So at number of places in alarms we can use there. At automatic bulbs we can use, means in automatic lights we can use it. So a number of places that where we can use it. So I think now whatever we have discussed here about the questions on photodiodes and questions on PN junction diode and rectifiers, that is now clear. So only I think half of the chapter and its question that is asked in your previous year board examination papers we have discussed now. So in next class, student, we will discuss rest of the special purpose diode and the question asked from that. After that, obviously automatic the whole of the topic will be covered there. And later, some of the questions are asked from the circuit based, means in the case of forward and reverse, how can we find out the current? Only some of the numerical problems are here. So we will discuss that in the next class also. So I think if all the things are now clear, so let's just end the class here today.